strange thing. We have lived, many of us, our entire lives in something of a unique period in human history, when we could, with reasonable expectations, assume that whatever disease we happen to catch, the strong likelihood was that we would be fine. In truth, it is 102 years since the world was last threatened by what some people call a pandemic. There have been worries, there have been scares, but for all of us alive today, this is new. I was talking with Angelo just before the service and saying, the last time something like this happened was the 1918 flu, and he said, oh yes, I remember, my father told me about that. He was in Asia Minor at the time, with the Greek army. This is history for us, and here we are again. What this means for us tonight, we are accustomed to praying the services of the church in times when, all things being equal, everything is well. What we are asking for as we come and offer our prayers to the Lord so often are not small things, or we could say they are mundane things. We pray for wisdom for our children, for peace and harmony in our marriages, for success and stability in our lives. These are good prayers. They are honest and authentic prayers. But they were not the prayers, the needs that inspired the composition of our church's services. And especially the prayers to Panagia, the prayers to the Theotokos in Constantinople, were written and prayed and developed under constant, at least yearly, threat of plague, of sickness, or worse, foreign invasion, civil war, unforeseen death. All of these things that we pray that the Lord deliver us from, which seem distant from us. This is what these services are for. This is indeed why we are not closing the churches. Because in the face of sickness, Christians need to do what Christians have always done in time of sickness. We need to come and we need to offer prayers to God. Supplications to his saints that they pray for us as well, that we may be delivered from the dangers that surround us, and that we may be granted peace to face these troubles, that we may be granted love and endurance to serve those who are around us who need our help, and that we may be granted faith, hope, trust in our Lord. Let whatever comes in these days, we may hold fast to him and find ourselves together at the end of the journey, when all pain and sorrow and suffering are wiped. plague is truly a permanent distant memory on the day of the new creation, when we stand before the face of the Lord and rejoice in the healing and transformation of all that is. In these days of trouble, we gather to pray, to do what Christians have always done, placing our trust in the Lord. Speaking practically for a moment, I still hear many voices throughout the country, throughout the state, and throughout the church. Some say this is overblown, it's exaggerated, it's unnecessary. And we pray that they are right. And others say it's the end of the world as we know it. And we pray that they are wrong. But our action, first of all, we are blessed because as Orthodox Christians, we are not left alone to make these decisions. We are a hierarchical church. We stand in obedience under the leadership of our bishops and of our archbishops and of our patriarchs. And therefore, the actions that we have taken are actions of obedience. So that we do not need to worry about the many voices saying this and saying that. We simply need to obey. To be careful, but not paranoid. To be prudent, but not to live in fear. And to remember always the words of the Lord, spoken 2,000 years ago to his disciples before they suffered anything at all, and to all of us throughout the ages who have stood in hope of the Lord's salvation. He said, "Peace I give to you. My peace I leave with you, not peace like the world gives, but my peace I give to you." So be of good cheer, he says to us, "for I have overcome the world." And therefore, in this service, in preparation for the joy of Pascha, in celebration of and meditation upon the mystery of our Lord's incarnation, his presence with us, we say as well, be of good cheer, be at peace, for our God has overcome the world, and all will be well. Be assured, Ola Allah Tayyi. We have left the icon up on the Sulaya because those instructions we have received are that nobody is to venerate the icon of Anahia by kissing it. So please, if you would, come forward. Incline your head, make the sign of the cross, and go in peace and in care and in safety to your home. May God be with you all.